This video will show you how to quantize notes in FL Studio. There's a lot more to quantizing than just aligning notes to the grid. You can also use it to make some creative rhythmic variations and effects that you may have never thought of otherwise. So, keep on watching.
This is a Firewalk production.
Quantizing is used when you have recorded something into the piano roll, and you want to quickly align all the notes to the grid. There's a few ways to do this. Let's record something first so that we can have something to work with. As you can see, it's not perfect. Even if you seem to have nailed it, your accuracy will be influenced by your system's latency. That's the time it takes from when you hit a key on your keyboard until you hear the sound through your speakers. Latency will vary for everyone, and it depends on how fast your computer is, your settings, and how big your project is. A very large project may force you to use a very high buffer setting, and then you'll end up with a lot of latency, despite having a very powerful computer. In situations like that, it's more difficult to get it right, and you'll need to use quantizing to correct it. If you want to learn how to optimize FL Studio for best performance, then check out my How to Get Better CPU Performance in FL Studio tutorial. You can find the link for it in the description below. Let's get back on track. Okay, to quantize this, we click here, select Tools, and then Quantize. We can also use the keyboard to bring it up. Just hold the Alt key and press Q. Here we have two knobs, start time and duration. Sometimes quantized notes can seem a bit static and robotic. If you want it to sound more natural and human, you can play around with these knobs for a different effect. Next, we have this menu. We have a few options. You can, for example, choose not to quantize the duration of a note. Perhaps you want to quantize the start time but not the end time, and so on. The third knob seen here is the sensitivity knob. That's basically how much of the quantize effect is being applied. On the bottom, we have pan, velocity, release, pitch, and so on. These are pretty self-explanatory. The last thing I want to talk about is this folder button. If you click it, you'll be able to load different quantize templates. Here, you'll have a lot of presets to choose from, like various snap settings, humanize, swing, and grooves. Note that when you click on a template, the grid changes. This makes it easier to select the right one. Unlike linear DAWs, FL Studio doesn't have the ability to add swing per track. If you want to apply swing to just one pattern separately, the easiest way to achieve that is to use the Quantize tool and then load one of the swing templates, like so. You can play around with these various templates to achieve some very interesting results. If you just want to quickly quantize and move on, you can use the Quick Quantize or Quick Quantize Start Time option as seen here. Note that the keyboard shortcuts for each command are displayed here. I encourage you to memorize these shortcuts as they will speed up your workflow dramatically. The last thing I want to cover is the auto quantize. It's possible to make FL Studio automatically quantize your MIDI input. That way you don't have to go in and change it afterwards. Here I have a blank project. I'll just add a VST and create a new pattern real quick so that we have something to record. To turn on auto quantizing, you will need to click this little magnet here. Next to it, you'll see a menu showing the various snap settings available. I'll go with the 1/4 beat, 1/4 setting. Before we hit record, let's right-click on the record button to bring up the record preference menu. To the right, here are additional quantize settings. We can now choose one or more of these settings. I'll just select the note start time, but you can of course select several or all of them at the same time if you wish. Now we are ready to record. I'll just enable the metronome first. This will make it easier since there's no beat going on in this project yet. Next, click the record button to arm for recording, and then press the play button when you're ready. That's it. As you can see, the start time for all the notes are perfectly aligned to the grid. That's it. You should now have a basic understanding of how quantizing works in FL Studio. I hope this was helpful. If you liked the video, please like, share, and comment. I'm uploading new tutorials and templates every week, so make sure to subscribe to this channel so that you won't miss out. Is there any specific tutorial you'd like me to make? Or perhaps you have a question? Just leave me a comment below.